نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله، أرسله المولى تبارك وتعالى بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون، عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد، إخوة الإسلام، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى المولى سبحانه وتعالى، وهو الذي أوصانا في محكم التنزيل، فقال عز وجل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. My dear brothers in Islam, as you know, we have been talking about the pillars of faith, and you already, alhamdulillah, covered five of them, and today, inshallah, we'll talk about the last one, which is the belief in al-qada wal-qadar. Al-qada wal-qadar. And this is very important, to believe in whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed and wrote based on His knowledge. So we know that nothing in this world, in this universe, no matter how tiny is it, never happened without the knowledge of Allah, without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah azza wa jal has wisdom that we may not comprehend some of the wisdom of whatever going on. Sometimes we like something, but it's not impact in our interest in the long run. And some other time, we dislike something, while in fact it is for our happiness in this world and in the hereafter. So for the Muslim, he should understand what does it mean to believe in Al-Qadr. The belief in Al-Qadr, my dear brothers, based on the knowledge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the belief in Allah azza wa jal, that Allah azza wa jal, the perfect, the most high, knows everything that happened and everything that will happen, and that His knowledge encompasses everything. Even the thing that didn't happen, if it happened, how it will happen, beyond our imagination. This is the knowledge of Allah Azza wa Jal that cover everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah At-Talaq, لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. That you know, that you may know that Allah has power over all things, and that Allah surrounds, comprehend all things in His knowledge. Nothing is hidden from the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This also based on the fact, believe in the Al-Qadr, based on the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, open His knowledge, He wrote everything. He, the most high and perfect, wrote the measures of created beings that will exist, and the establishment of the hour, the time of the hour, as Allah Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Alam ta'lam anna Allah ya'lamu ma fi as-samawati ma fi as-sama'i wal ard inna dhalika fi kitab inna dhalika 'ala Allah yaseer. Whatever happened in this world, it's already written, recorded, even before it's happened. The meaning of this verse, do you not know that Allah knows all that is in heaven and on earth? Verily, it is all in a book. Indeed, that is easy for Allah. A book does mean it was recorded in a lawh al-mahfuz. So, Nothing occurred in this universe except with the knowledge and the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever Allah wills will happen. And whatever He will not to occur will not happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Surah number 76, وَمَا تَشَاءُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ يَشَاءَ اللَّهُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. Nothing happened unless Allah permitted. So my dear brothers, the belief in Al-Qadr, which is divine decree, includes four pillars. Remember this. Some people say, believe in Al-Qadr, they say, yes, I believe in Al-Qadr. But he doesn't realize what this include. Believing in Al-Qadr includes four matters. You need to remember. This include four pillars, which is a person must believe. And everything that occurs in this universe has these four pillars gathered together in when it's occurred. Anything's happened, if you analyze it, you will find all these four matters, it's already met and it was included. We mentioned some. They are, first, the belief in al-ilm, knowledge, the knowledge of Allah. So nothing happened in the universe except after He know about it. Nothing happened without the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second, the belief in al-kitaba, which is writing down, written down. So nothing happened except after it has been written in al-lawh al-mahfuz, preserved tablets. The belief also in al-mashi'ah. What does it mean, mashi'ah? The will of Allah. So nothing happened in this worldly life except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills for it to happen. So this is the third one. The fourth one, believe in Allah, that Allah is the creator of everything, as He subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allahu khaliqu kulli shay wa huwa ala kulli shay'in wakeel. Allah is the creator of all things. So, four matters it will be included in Al-Qadr. And we need to remember this. The knowledge, the writing, the Mashiach, and the creation of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So the belief in Al-Qadr, my dear brothers, has many tremendous benefits for the life of the Muslim. In fact, why Muslim, alhamdulillah, Muslim who believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla, they find relief no matter what calamity face them. While non-believers, they cannot face these types of problems. As you know, the rate, the percentage of those who commit suicide or they kill themselves among non-Muslim is very high, while among the Muslim is very rare. You see, the one who is not believing in Allah, he doesn't believe in, you know, that Allah planned this, he has no hope. So what he do? If he lost his job, lost his child, lost his wife, so he will be, you know, in troubles that he cannot face because there's no one to turn to. So he will go and kill himself. And you think this is the only way to get out of his problems. While alhamdulillah, the Muslim, no matter what calamity that he face, he will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So some of the benefits of believing in Al-Qadr is, and inshallah I'll explain this, the first thing, the real reliance in Allah. Real reliance in Allah. At-tawakkul ala Allah. So, what's the meaning of at-tawakkul ala Allah? التوكل على that you rely on Allah and you accept whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala planned for you. Because you know that He always will choose for you based on His knowledge better than what you choose for yourself. But there's, my dear brothers, difference between التوكل and التواكل. Two words. توكل, تواكل. توكل is recommended. تواكل is not correct. What's the difference between these two words? التوكل, that you do and you take all the means. You do your part. You want to succeed in your, you get degree, you have to study hard. You want to get a child, you have to get married. You will not get a child without married, without wife. See, you need to take bil asbab. And after you take all the means that you can do to achieve your goal, don't depend, be careful, don't depend on the means and you think it will get you what you want. But then depend on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you said, I did what I can, and all the success and all goods is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So depend on Allah, put your trust in Allah. Tawakul, which is misunderstanding for, you know, Al-Qadr, is the one who just say, oh Allah give me, oh Allah do for me, and he doesn't take the means. A person who pray day and night and say, oh Allah give me righteous son, mashallah, that's good goal. But he doesn't want to get married. Where he will get this son? SubhanAllah. Allah Azza wa Jalla put rules in this universe. So we follow and respect the rules which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second one, one of the fruits of believing in Al-Qadr, being pleased and submissive and having tranquility in accepting when affliction occurs or when not achieve what you want, even though the means have been taken to achieve. You did your part, you try hard, you study hard, or you filled many applications or certain application for a certain job. After you did all this, you didn't get it. What should you do? Then you remember that Allah knows this and Allah chose not to give it to you at this time. And you say, oh Allah, accept what you planned for me. And if you have rida, and we talk about this, inshallah, maybe make one khutbah about rida, then you will find tranquility in your heart, peace of mind. Say Alhamdulillah, and Allah may test you. And then when you show your true belief, true reliance in Allah Azza wa Jal, you will get what you want or maybe better. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give you a chance to marry the woman that you choose. Just a matter of love. Because Allah knows that if you marry this woman, your life in the future will be miserable. So may Allah Azza wa Jalla push her away from your way. And then you'll find the one that will be source of your happiness. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Azim. Wa nafa'ani wa iyaakum bima fihi min al-ayi wa al-dhikr al-hakim. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-Azim li wa lakum. Wa lisa'ir المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله. الحمد لله وكفى. والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى ومن سار على نهجه واقتفى. My dear brothers, the third benefit or fruits of believing in Al-Qadr is the person being thankful for the blessing and being conscientious, nor self amazed because of what he knows, or that if he were not to get what he wants. Some people, when they achieve something, they forgot about the one who gave it to them. So he is proud of himself. Yeah, well, I'm smart. I know how to do it. I know how to plan. They do that like this. It's not your success, but it is what? Tawfiq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who paved the way in front of you to achieve this goal. So you should remember that whatever blessing that you got, remember that it was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't be proud of yourself. And Allah Azza wa Jalla gave us an example of Qarun. You know Qarun, the time of Musa alayhi salam. Why he told us about this example? To learn a lesson. So the Muslim, whenever he gets any blessing, he knows this is from Allah, alhamdulillah. Be thankful, you will get more. شَكَرْتُمْ لَهَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. You be thankful for Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah will give you more. On the other side, as you know this life, it's not all the days are happy days. We have happy days, sad days. Sometimes we are in ease, sometimes in hardship. So this is the nature of life. And Allah Azza wa Jal tests us in the good and in the bad. So the Muslim, whenever any calamity faced him, he should be what? He should be patient. Remember that this is the plan of Allah. Oh Allah, whatever you plan for me, I accept it. I submit, even it is hurt the heart. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when his son Ibrahim died, what he said? عند القلب لا يحزن وإن العين لا تدمع ولا نقول إلا ما يرضى. Surely the heart is very sad. The tears flow up from our eyes, but we say nothing but that which please our Lord. Be patient. Always. It's not the end of this life. Remember that Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you more. Look at the blessing of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And when the Muslim, he knows that everything from Allah, whenever any calamity happened, he should train himself not only to be patient but to feel pleased even if it is like this, for one reason: that Allah planned it, Allah wanted it, I love it for the sake of Allah, I accept it for the sake of Allah, because I love Allah and I trust that my Lord chose for me whatever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this in the Quran. When Allah Azza wa Jalla said in Surah Al-Hadid, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن نَبْرَأَهَا إِنَّ ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسَوْا عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَحُوا بِمَا آتَاكُمْ وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. Verse number 23 in Surah Al-Hadid. The meaning of this verse: no calamity befalls on the earth or in yourselves, like losing someone, but is inscribed in the book of decree before we bring it into existence. Indeed, that is easy for Allah, in order that you not be sad over matters that you fail to get, nor rejoice because of that which has been given to you. And Allah doesn't like and Allah doesn't like the prideful boaster. So my dear brothers, we need to get the real knowledge of the Aqeedah. And one of them is the al-belief in the Qadr. And by this, alhamdulillah, we cover all the pillars of the Aqeedah. Those brothers who didn't attend the khutbah or previous khutbah, which talk about the pillars or the articles of faith, they can go back to the list of recorded khutbah and they can watch them So they will have the complete, inshallah, picture about this important matter. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَلَاكِدَ وَصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم صل وسلم وأنت مبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد اللهم بعد الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين الأئمة المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين ومن سار على نهجهم إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين واحن حوزة الدين واجعل اللهم هذا البلد آمنا رخاء سخاء وسائر بلاد المسلمين اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا ودورنا وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا واجعل ولايتنا في من خافك واتقاك واتبع رضاك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم وفق إمامنا ولي أمرنا بتوفيقك وأيده بتأييدك وانصر به الإسلام والمسلمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا مجيب الدعوات عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروا على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون